before people get their copy of the book, and we are talking with Craig LeMasters about the book Unstuck, how to unlock and activate the wisdom of others. Before you get your copy, Craig can give you the four steps at a high level right now. So what are the four steps for us as organizations, as teams, and as individuals to get unstuck?
Yeah. And let me just say, Kevin, everything I'm going to share right now is my own story, my own experience. Again, not a trained consultant, academic. A lot of that work is very helpful. This is wisdom-based stuff I'll share with you. And then my body of work the last 5 years, which is, you know, hundreds of really cool companies around the world. So the four steps, again, I like to keep things super simple, as you probably already picked up on. But here's what works. Number one, leadership team has to have a very high humility quotient. Okay, I talk about, you know, get a whole chapter in the little book about humility. Without humility, we're not going to admit we're stuck. And more importantly, we're not going to allow outside wisdom in. Okay, so step number one is humility. And I can't emphasize, we've actually passed up business opportunities because the C-suite or the CEO in particular may not have the humility that we want to see to make our stuff work. Okay, so number one is humility. Number two is, we have to define the destination. It's shocking to me how many companies, and even really, really good companies, I mean, brands you would know, everyday brands, that just don't have clarity around the destination. Okay. I call it A to B in the book. Again, I think we overblow this. We can spend, you know, millions of dollars in consulting help to do this stuff. Your team, we should be able to do this in a couple hours on a whiteboard. And so that's what I would propose. So step number two, though, you got to know where your B is. And again, I want to be really granular here, Kevin. I'm not talking about change the world through this kind of thing. That's a vision. I'm talking about, you know, I have my little coffee cup here. I'm a coffee company and I want to make pens. Okay. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. So if making pens is your B, that's fine, right? When, how many, like we really push for granularity. So humility, the destination. And then the third, which is super important, is we actually draw this learning ecosystem. So if the new thing I'm going to go do, my destination is a pen maker, I'm going to put the whatever that detail is about the pen in the middle. And we're just going to do an ecosystem, which is actually identifying the wisdom gaps. And again, this is, I know this is going to sound really simple, but it works, which is just to say, if we look at the organizational wisdom, knowledge and experience, how much of it do we have in the company today to make pens? Oh, and by the way, what are the three or four circles, if you picture an ecosystem, what are the three or four circles of wisdom that are imperatives to be a really good pen maker? Okay, this is straightforward. You'd be shocked how many companies never do this stuff. Right. And so what happens is we put those circles around the middle of the pen, we start to get this very clear picture of, wow, we can go do this. Or, you know what, we've got some wisdom gaps, as I would call it, we have to fill. So once we know the gaps, then the next part is you got to go fill them. Okay. How do we do that? You have to be granular. Again, what I'm looking for, if being a great pen maker is to make ink, then I want to know the granularity of the wisdom is required to know how to make ink. So I want to go find wisdom, a person. Again, when I say wisdom, it is people. It is a person that has amazing ink knowledge and experience. And then the last step is, once we've accumulated those people, and we use like a little board format, we usually only need two or three, depending on how the complexity of the topic. But once I got the ink person, once I got the, I don't know much about pens, the clip person.
It's working.
But you get the idea. But once I get these wisdom people, I put them in a room and we call it activate. Well, it's a fancy word. All it is we're going to extract that wisdom on the pieces you're stuck on, because you only knew how to do a couple of things. And now we're going to take their wisdom, because they've already done those component parts, and literally within hours, pull together the pathway to get to B, right? And again, it's not a hypothetical, it's not an academic, it's not a research-based pathway. It's actually people that have made the ink and made the clip and made the top. And guess what? You can do that very fast. And the reason we can do it fast is it's the right wisdom in the room. So those are the four steps.
Well, and super simple. We can get there because we started by knowing where we were trying to go.
That's right. Yeah. Don't underestimate it. I mean, again, we have clients, and our company was okay at this. Sometimes we knew exactly, but I would argue, Kevin, and you probably see this a lot as well, most don't. Or if they do, it's pretty high level. I mean, I have an advantage in this work because I ran a big company, moved up in the company. So at every level, I got to learn this stuff. So I'm not going to let people get away with the big picture, platitudinal kind of, here's right. my destination. It's like, it doesn't work. You know, we're going to get really granular, but you're exactly right. If there's humility, we understand the destination, and then we're honest, candid about those wisdom gaps, game over. We're going to solve it quickly. And that's the beauty of wisdom.